Good morning, children. Once again, welcome to online classes. So, in the last video, I told you that this year 8th standard science and maths syllabus has changed. So, I have started with a new lesson, crop production and management. So, as I told you earlier, also the lessons which I completed in the previous syllabus, that is chemistry one lesson and biology one lesson. So, please, whatever the notes you have written, let it be like that only. You can read it for bridge course exam. So this one will continue for this coming academic year. So I have started with the crop production and management. So in that agriculture practices I have started it, and I have completed preparation of soil and sowing. I told you all how to prepare the soil before you cultivate the crops there. The turning and treating the processes called as tilting, so with the help of some implements like plow, hoe and cultivator. So that is preparation of soil is done using those all implements before to cultivate the crops and all. So next one I have completed sowing also, how to sow the seeds in the field like with the help of seed drill machines and all. So today I am going to start with adding manure and fertilizers. Even plants also need some energy to grow. So for that purpose we use manure and fertilizers to get the better yield, okay, for the growth of plants. So the substance which is added to the soil in the form of nutrients is called manure. What is that? The substance which is added to the soil in the form of nutrients, is called manure. So substance which are added to the soil means which are mixed with the soil to grow the crops, that is called manure. So soil supplies nutrients, minerals, mineral nutrients to the crops to grow it in a good way. So in certain areas, crops are grown without giving any gaps. Like farmers used to grow the crops after crops between the two crops because there will not be any gap there. So in the uncultivated area only they will grow the crops one after the other. So if you grow like that, there will be some less of nutrients in the soil, so that the next crop sow the seeds, it will not grow in the good way. So you should not grow like that. Okay, that is not the good way to grow the crops. Means in some certain areas farmers will do like that. So continuous growing of crops, the soil loses the nutrients. So it should not grow like that. Therefore, farmers have to add some manure. Before doing like that, they have to add some manure to the soil so that they can get a good yield of crops. Otherwise, they have to leave uncultivated between the two crops. Then only they will get the good crops. Okay, that is also one method of getting the good yield. Okay. So manure is nothing but the decomposition of dead plants and animals. Okay, what farmers will do, you know, they collect the waste of animal and plants and they dump in the pit. Okay, pit, and allow it to some days for decompose. And the decomposition is done by the microorganisms. Okay, it is done by microorganisms. So that decomposed manure is called as, that matter is used as a manure. It is called a manure and it is called as an organic manure also. Okay, what is manure? The farmers collect the dead plants and animal waste and they dump in the pit for some days to decompose. Okay, pit means teggu. They'll dump in the pit for some days. They will allow it to decompose. After some days, the decomposition is done by using in the presence of the microorganisms which are present in the soil. So that matter is used as manure. That matter is used as manure. That is good for organic cropping. Okay. So that manure is good compared to the fertilizers. Fertilizers are nothing but the chemical substance which are present in the form of nutrients. There are some rich in nutrients, they are rich in nutrients, but most of the farmers nowadays, instead of doing this all organic manure and all, they are bringing the fertilizers from the outside which are mixed with the chemicals. All they are mixed up with the chemicals and some are rich in the nutrients, but even farmers are getting good yield by using that also. But one more thing, one reason is that by using the fertilizers, it leads to water pollution also. So water pollution, you know that the fertilizers which are sprinkled on the crops and all, it falls on the soil in the when you leave the water for the crops and all, that fertilizer will mix up with the water and it flows with the water, that water will go and join to some other rivers and all. So like that, some water pollution will be there. So that's why instead of doing that, we can substitute the fertilizers with the organic manure. Otherwise, we have to leave the uncultivated field between the two crops. That is better instead of doing that. So, fertilizers are the chemical substance. Okay, that is also good. But compared to the fertilizers, the organic manure is very good to growth of the crops. Okay. So, they are manufactured in factories. Fertilizers are manufactured in the factories. Factories and some examples are urea, phosphate. Urea, ammonia, phosphate. So these are the some examples of fertilizers. Okay, they are manufactured in the factories. Okay, and they are used in the crops of maize, paddy, wheat. Okay, so the excessive use of fertilizers leads to water pollution also. So therefore, in order to maintain the fertility of soil, we have to substitute fertilizers in with the organic manure. So the use of manure inspires the texture as well as water retaining capacity, and it replenishes the soil with all the nutrients. Okay, so what are the differences between the manure and fertilizer? Fertilizer and manure. Fertilizers and manure. What are fertilizers? Fertilizer is an inorganic salt. Fertilizer is an inorganic salt. Okay. So what is manure? Manure is a natural substance. Manure is a natural substance obtained by the decomposed of human waste and plant residues. Okay, so second point. So fertilizer is prepared in factories. It is prepared in factories. Okay. So manure is can be prepared in the fields. In phase. Okay, third one, fertilizer does not provide any humus to the soil. Lot of humus to the soil. Okay. So fertilizers are very rich in plant nutrients. Okay. Like nitrogen, phosphorus. So manure is relatively less rich in plant nutrients. Okay. See, fertilizers is an inorganic salt. It is an inorganic. Manure is a natural substance obtained by the decomposition of cattle dung, human waste and plant residues. So it is prepared in factories. Yes, this is fertilizers are manufactured in the factories. This is done in the fields. I told you all farmers collect all the plants and animals waste and they dump in the pit for some days to decompose. The decomposition of that matter is called as a manure. So does not provide any humus to the soil. Yes, fertilizers does not provide any humus to the soil. But here provides lot of humus to the soil because it is an organic matter, so it will provide a humus to the soil. And very rich in plant nutrients like nitrogen, phosphorus and potassium. This is very less rich in plant nutrients because it is an organic matter which is made up of the waste of animals and plants. But here it is a chemicalized and prepared in the factories and all, so it will be having very rich nutrients. Okay, so these are the differences between the fertilizers and manure. I hope you have understood, children. That's why we are not getting so tasty food nowadays as we used to get in the early days, like in our parents' time and all. So they used to eat very good, that is organic one. in our, this is all, we are eating somewhat like artificial. So some fruits are also now ripened artificially, like doing some injections and all. So this is all going on now. Can't do anything. So we have to adjust with the nature. Next. So advantages of mango. Advantages of mango. Okay, what are the advantages by using the mango? What are the advantages we are going to get? So that is an, you know that it is an organic matter considered better than the fertilizers. So most of the farmers now also they are using the organic manure only. So it enhances the water holding. It enhances the water holding capacity to the soil. Water holding capacity. Water holding capacity to the soil. Okay. So next one, it makes the soil porous due to which exchange of gases becomes easy. Makes the soil porous. Porous due to which the exchange of gases becomes easy. The exchange of gases becomes easy. Becomes easy. Next. It increases the number of friendly microbes. It increases the number of friendly microbes. Okay. Fourth one, it improves the texture of soil. It improves the texture of soil. So these are the advantages of manure. Means it is in a good way. Using the manure is also a good way. So this is called advantages. It enhances the water holding capacity to the soil. Means it gives strength to the soil to hold the capacity which the crops will be absorbed. The roots will absorb the water and it passes to all the parts of the plants. Okay. So it enhances the water holding capacity to the soil. That manure will give that strength to the soil to hold the water. It makes the soil porous due to which the exchange of gases becomes easy. Yes, the gases which are present here, the minerals and all gases which are present there, it becomes very easy to exchange the gases from soil to the plants and all. So it increases the number of friendly microbes, the microbes which are present in the soil. It increases the number of friendly microbes. It increases the microbes which are present in the soil. It improves the texture of soil also. Improves the texture of soil. So this completes the adding manure and fertilizers. So in the next video I am going to continue with the next topic. Okay.